I'll tell you what I heard from the Syrian people that I met with, Jake, walking down the streets in Aleppo, in Damascus, hearing from them. They expressed happiness and joy at seeing an American walking through their streets. But they expressed a question. They said, why is it that the United States, its allies and other countries are providing support, are providing arms to terrorist groups like al-Nusra, al-Qaeda, Ahrar al-Sham, ISIS, who are on the ground there raping, kidnapping, torturing, and killing the Syrian people, children, men, women, people of all ages. They asked me, why is the United States and its allies supporting these terrorist groups who are destroying Syria when it was al-Qaeda who attacked the United States on 9/11, not Syria? I didn't have an answer for them.
Obviously, the United States government denies providing any sort of help to the terrorist groups that you're talking about. They say they provide help for the rebel groups. Tell us more
about that. The reality is, Jake, the reality is, and I'm glad you brought up that point, because this is an often talked about thing by people like Adam Kinzinger and others saying, well, we've got to support the moderate rebels. Every place that I went, every person that I spoke to, I asked this question to them. And without hesitation, they said, there are no moderate rebels. Who are these moderate rebels that people keep speaking of? Regardless of the name of these groups, the strongest fighting force on the ground in Syria is al-Nusra, or al-Qaeda and ISIS. That is a fact. There's a number of different other groups. All of them essentially are fighting alongside, with, or under the command of the strongest group on the ground that's trying to overthrow Assad. The Syrian people recognize and they know that if President Assad is overthrown, then al-Qaeda or a group like al-Qaeda that has been killing Christians, killing people simply because of their religion or because they won't support their terror activities, they will take charge of all of Syria. This is the reality that the people of Syria are facing on the ground, and why they are pleading with us here in the United States to stop supporting these terrorist groups. Let the Syrian people themselves determine their future, not the United States, not some foreign country.
And we've been showing video of your trip, from your trip. In the minute we have left, tell us the most striking image you have from your visit to this war-torn region.
Yeah, Jake, you know, the destruction is very real, both on the physical buildings and the things that people have gone through, looking into their eyes and hearing firsthand from a girl who is now 19, but who, when she was 14 years old, these rebels that people say we should continue supporting, they came and kidnapped her. They raped her multiple times. They killed her father in cold blood right in front of her and her little brother. All she is asking for, literally, is for the United States to stop supporting these so-called rebel groups, stop supporting these terrorists, so that the Syrian people can begin to try to get back to some semblance of normalcy in their lives.
Congresswoman Tulsi Gabbard, Democrat of Hawaii, thank you so much. We appreciate your coming and telling us this story.
Thanks, Jake.